Friday. I just finished up teaching a fitness class here at Viva. This is a ballroom, dance, and fitness studio where we do yoga as well. So I cover classes here about twice a week. Friday morning is all finished up. It's about 7 a.m. and I'm gonna go get one of the best cups of coffee around right next door.
Go for it.
So after my morning class at Viva, I just got some good work done on my computer, did a lot of reading, and then I trained a few clients at my place. So it's like almost 5 o'clock and I still haven't done either workout yet. So my outdoor workout today is going to be some yoga, some stretching, and some meditation as well, probably. So I wanted to talk a bit about meditation for some people that don't know much about it or are new to it. And right off the bat, if you think meditation is about completely blocking out your thoughts and not thinking about anything at all, that is not necessarily true. It is about letting your thoughts happen and letting yourself process them. So the point in where that comes from about being thoughtless is that eventually, if you just let that happen and you let your thoughts run through you, eventually you'll reach a point where you are thoughtless. And you won't know if you reach that point because you'll be thoughtless. So just wanted to throw that out there. So next time you want to try meditating, I recommend just getting into a comfortable spot, laying on the floor, and basically taking a nap. It's the easiest to be done when you exhaust your body a bit first. So that's why you always, in a yoga class, you always have that ending shavasana where you lay down and you meditate. It's after you've moved through your body, you've gotten out all the aches and the itches and the jitters, and you've kind of tired yourself out in a way so that now your mind can relax and it's not thinking about your body, because your body's very distracting for your mind. So try it after like a workout or a yoga session or a run or a bike ride, and then go ahead and just relax, close your eyes, and don't fall asleep. But if you do, that's fine too. So give it a shot.
I wanted to do a voiceover for this routine just to help any of you out if you want to start stretching more. And if you have any low back or hip tightness, I always start on my stomach to offset any sitting I've done throughout the day. So if you have a job where you sit a lot, some back bends are going to be your best friend to help fix any pain or tightness. Now I'm getting into lizard pose, as well as twisted lizard here, where I bend my knee and grab my foot. It's a pretty deep stretch for the hips and the quad if you want to give it a shot. I always throw in cat-cows in between poses, as well as some shoulder swings, Michael Phelps drill there to loosen them up. That was camel pose, another great back bend. If you want to give it a try, just grab one heel at a time and then thrust the body forward. Here's pigeon pose, a lovely pose that really opens up those hips and the IT band. Always start by trying to get tall and then fold forward and breathe. Now I'm just stretching out those shoulders, trying to touch my fingertips behind my back, as well as some neck stretches, because the neck never gets enough love. I always feel these in my shoulders too, in the front of my shoulders. Now I'm just getting into some relaxation and meditation. Notice my belly moving up and down as I breathe, just letting the mind wander and taking big deep breaths in through the belly, not the chest. Now just waking myself back up, loosening up those hamstrings one more time before I have some fun and get into some handstands.
First time I ever done that. 1% better every day. Okay, we just squatted a shit ton. Now making imbalance. Here we go. Come on. Yeah. You see, it's always hard the first time you try something you've never done before, right?
Definitely.
Then it gets easier.
What the hell is going on over here?
Maddie, are you going to do a full today?
Maybe. If I can.
I'm doing a double flip.
Double backflip?
Yeah.
Front or back?
Do one right now.
A backflip? Here, hold my caterpillar.
Easy. Ha 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 ha!
That was close, right?
Super.
I've never seen this much chalk in one bucket. Fly away now.
You just let go.
Oh my
right
god.
There, right there, you let go.
Oh,
that was
yes.
It. That was good.
You did it. Was it scary?
No. That was good.
See you like that. It's too short again.
Yes. No way. Two in a row. Three. Oh.
Sometimes I get a little nervous.
There you go. Like a back handspring.
Oh, I forgot the front flip.
There you go.
Oh my. Like.
Wow, all my handsprings are crooked.
It's a baby one compared to last time.
Oh yeah. But yours is nicer than mine.
What's yours? No, it's good. It's there.
Damn, guess I just didn't go hard.
Yo, who let the dog out?
Oh my god! Wow!
That was refreshing. Oh shit, we're going on the road.